is that back? Because I've been dying for that to come back.
Drink it up!
What the?
All right, horns up, metalheads, time for another edition of Rockin' Metal Revival. I'm him, he's me, and we're a happy family.
There's no she.
No, all right. What's going on, brother?
I'm doing all right. How are you?
What's that, 333, only half is evil?
Yep, half is evil.
Nice.
Yeah. Feeling better than Ted.
All right, how was Priest?
Priests were awesome. Saxon was awesome. That was cool.
All right.
I mainly went to see Saxon.
Yeah.
And they didn't disappoint.
They didn't disappoint?
No.
All right, we'll talk about that in a little bit. Why don't we, next hour, we'll talk to Rob Rock from Impellitteri. I'm really digging this CD called Venom.
Yeah, good stuff, man.
Good stuff. You know Michael, our friend in Poland, or wherever the hell he's living now?
Yeah.
He posted their video last week. And
oh,
I'm
yeah?
Like, well, stay tuned, brother. We got something for you.
Ah, nice. See?
So,
it's that telepathic stuff
that's right.
We send back and forth.
Exactly. Across the big pond.
Yep.
All right, since Saxon kicked ass the other night, why don't we open up the show with Little Saxon? This is from the CD Sacrifice. This is called Warriors of the Road.
Nice.
Name
of the tour, too, I think.
Is it?
Yeah.
All right, we'll kick it off right here. Here's Saxon on Rockin' Metal Revival.
Pushing hard down the back, trying to focus on the trail.
Warwick from Black Star Riders, and you're listening to the one, the only, the truly great rock and metal revival.
Reality's a lonely place. One way to
From Hellbent for Leather, there's a classic from Judas Priest, the title track. Did they play that one the other night?
Yes, they did. And yeah. He rode his motorcycle out. It wasn't like the end of the show, though. It was like three quarters of the way through.
Yeah.
Came out with that. And yeah, left the motorcycle out there for most of the rest of the show.
So how was the Rosemont Theater in Chicago?
It was pretty cool, man. Except for the assholes who kept standing up in front of me.
Yeah.
Yeah. You know, I'm up in the balcony like seven rows back, and person in row, the second row, just couldn't sit their fucking ass down. Everybody behind him wanted to sit down, was just waiting, but they wouldn't, fuckers wouldn't sit down.
I
person
probably
in front of
went.
Him was sitting down. Yeah, you could have.
I'd have walked up and tossed him right over the fucking edge.
Yeah, that would have got him out of the way.
Yeah.
I would have done that if I could have reached a damn.
Yeah.
But yeah, it was, could see for Saxon because everybody was sitting down. But yeah, great show though. Fucking cool.
So Saxon, did they play a lot of new stuff, or was it mostly old stuff?
Sacrifice, only a new song.
Yeah.
Everything else was the old stuff, yeah.
And
a lot,
then,
lot of cool old tunes, man.
How about Alfred? Could he do it? Can he still do it?
He can't hit the high notes.
Yeah?
You know, he starts off a little lower in some songs and stuff, but yeah, he's still a metal guy.
Metal
god. You don't fuck with him, man.
Yeah,
yeah, you can't slag him for as much as he's done. So.
Yeah, for metal. Good point. So you had a good time.
Yeah, it was a good time.
For a free show, you told me it cost you $200.
Yeah, I spent a lot on fucking merch.
Yeah? Well, that's one good thing, brother. You're conserving water because you don't do laundry very often.
Yeah, yeah. So I just, keep buying t-shirts. That way I don't have to wash them for a long time.
Nice.
Yeah.
Good.
Worked out good. Worked out well.
All right. Well, on today's show, we've got Rob Rock, the lead vocalist for the band Impellitteri. And they've been around a little bit, man. They've been around a while.
Yeah. Yeah. He's been around for quite a while. The guitarist there.
Yeah. Chris, he's a shredder.
He was in that Animetal or something.
That Rudy Sarzo
that
did?
That Rudy Sarzo was in. Yeah. That was one of their project bands for a while.
Nice.
Yeah.
But, you know, last couple shows we've been doing shredders on this show.
Doing a lot of shredding, man.
Yeah.
We're going to get like, we're like the back of the IRS or something there.
Exactly. In
back rooms of fucking corporations sitting there shredding stuff away.
Well, they'll come up next hour and got a lot of great songs. And you're going out to see your boys in Steel Panther tomorrow night.
Going to see the Panther tomorrow.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Fired up about that?
Hell yeah. That'd be cool, man.
Yeah.
Except that's a rave, so I'll just have to deal with that part. But, I'll deal with it.
Yeah, but you're like the after show party, so you'll probably get to see some tits.
Yeah. Oh, maybe. You never know.
Huh?
You never know.
You might get to see some old...
If I can see on the stage, I'll be able to see some tits, because there's going to be crazy drunk women getting up there.
You get to see some big boobs.
Oh, you think so? What do you think? Maybe. They might be have some big boobs.
Why don't we play an old metal school classic then in honor of your trip to see Steel Panther?
Okay. All right. We're rooting for big boobs.
Big boobs. Yes. All right. I'm rocking Metal Revival.
This is Lexi Fox from Metal School. You are listening to Rev and Jerry's Rock and Metal Revival.
So stupid that you don't even realize that you could put your penis in her vagina.
Yeah, but I'm the lead singer. I should put my penis in her vagina, dude.
Why don't I fucking put my penis in her vagina, dude?
Why don't we all three put our penis in her vagina, dude?
How you're fucking talking, dude.
Man, if my mom had tits like hers, I'd still be breastfeeding.
Yeah, dude, your mom is one hot piece of ass, dude.
I know. You're a dick.
We'll be right back. Hi, this is David Ellison from Megadeth, and you're listening to Rock and Metal Revival.
This one I made the call, the one that ends it all. Hey,
There's Megadeth and Tornado of Souls from Rust in Peace on Rock and Metal Revival. And dude,
that,
I want to.
That's worse. Is that worse than the Tornado of Sharks?
Could be Sharknado.
Yeah, Soulnado.
All seriousness to our listeners and our affiliates in Texas, man. Our hearts and thoughts go out to you. That's some fucked up stuff.
It's a mess down there, man. Fucking weather is just tearing shit up.
To Heath and everybody down there in the Houston, San Antonio, and the Austin areas, we hope everything's going cool for you. I mean, it doesn't look good on the news.
Yeah. It looks like that one Six Flags turned into a water park.
Yeah, it turned into a complete water park. I tell you what, there's people building arcs down there.
Yeah.
So, all right, it's time to do back to doing the stupid stuff that we normally do. How about some news of the weird?
Sure.
All right, woman uses obituary to declare Tom Brady's Deflategate's innocence. Oh, my God. A Massachusetts woman has used her own obituary to convey a final message to Tom Brady and Deflategate. The Boston.com reports that Patricia M. Shong of Auburn, Massachusetts, died on Monday, surrounded by her family. Her obituary says the 72-year-old enjoyed scrapbooking, weekly card nights, and spending time with her family. She'd have been a good woman for you, man.
That's exactly the same shit I do every day. Yeah. I love scrapbooking.
And I had to get her on Match.com for it. Well, it's too late now.
Oh, yeah.
She's a little stiff.
Well,
she would also
complain much, though.
No, she don't care about all the dope you smoke. She would like to set the record straight. She put in her obituary, Brady is innocent. And so is OJ.
Nice. All right.
Aspen man hires stuffed owl as his defense attorney.
Nothing about that other guy, the other Patriot, the murderer guy?
No, about Hernandez?
Yeah, Hernandez is innocent? No, nothing about him.
You heard that joke?
Uh-uh.
About a liar, a cheater, and a murderer walk into a bar?
Yeah.
Somebody else, the New England Patriots are here?
Yeah.
All right, anyways, Aspen man hires stuffed owl as his defense attorney.
And it probably won it for him, huh?
Ooh, okay.
Ooh, yeah.
Defending yourself in court is rarely recommended, but appointing a stuffed owl as your lawyer is a really bird-brained idea.
It must be on must be smoking something.
He's in Colorado. Nevertheless, that's who or what Charles Abbott brought as his attorney when he appeared in Aspen, Colorado courtroom on Tuesday. Abbott is accused of violating protection order involving his former roommate, Michael Stranahan. There we go. Let's see, Michael Strahan would have just bit him between that gap in his teeth.
Yeah.
The order filed against Abbott allegedly assaulted Stranahan at an Alcoholics Anonymous meeting. Oh, okay.
He wouldn't share his booze.
In court, Abbott placed a fuzzy stuffed owl at the defense table and told the judge that the owl named Solomon would be his legal counsel until a public defender was assigned to the case, according to the Aspen Times.
Nice. Well, hey.
Do you think he's going for the insanity plea?
I think he might. He's well off.
He's well on his way. Yeah. All right, a naked Florida man rescued after getting stuck on top of drawbridge.
Florida, I love
man,
it.
Man, I got to talk to my dad about living in Florida.
Yeah.
Florida first responders rescued a naked
man
from the top.
None of this happened until he moved down there.
I know. Exactly.
Did you notice
didn't it happen when you lived there?
Yeah.
A little bit of it.
It was my fault.
Yeah. From the top of the Fort Lauderdale drawbridge on Friday after he got stuck when the bridge was raised while he was walking across it naked. he was swimming in the water previously, and he jumped out of the water and went to go across the bridge, a bystander said. The bridge was coming up before he had gotten off the bridge.
Nice. What a dumbass.
They tried to initially reach the man with ladders, and they weren't quite tall enough. Instead, members of the Broward County Sheriff's Office scaled the structure. After wrapping the man in a towel, secured him in a harness fixed to the structure, when the bridge was slowly lowered back down.
Oh, they should have just lowered it fucking down and let him fall into the water.
Dude,
he's already been in the water. So
dude, this is the second time that somebody's had been rescued from that drawbridge. People in Florida are nuts, man.
Dude, don't they have like a signal? Hey, drawbridge, don't
we
they
have
some
things
come down? We should
move the Hookah Lounge Studios to Florida.
Yeah.
We would be fit in well there.
Yeah, we would. We'd be kings.
Campaign worker had one too many beers before sending fake news release about rival. Did Scott Walker do this? No, a campaign worker for a New Hampshire House hopeful has been charged with a felony for sending out fake news release saying the opponent had dropped out of the race.
At least didn't say they were dead.
Attorney General Joseph Foster says 28-year-old Carl Gibson of Concord was charged Friday with a felony voter suppression and misdemeanor court for distributing a false document. What an idiot.
Nice.
And let's
Don't get drunk and start sending out fucking news briefs.
Or just sending out your briefs.
Yeah. Well, you can send out pictures of your briefs.
You don't want any more of those?
No, please keep those to yourself.
And once again, we'll take a trip back down to Florida. Florida twins arrested for throwing bricks at each other. A Florida judge may have thrown the book at twin brothers accused of throwing bricks at each other.
He should have thrown more than a book, though.
Yeah, here's the best part. Michael and James Remulus, both 52.
52 years?
Were arrested Tuesday night.
Teenagers.
After the two started arguing with each other in the front yard of an Orange County home, the argument got doubly heated when Michael threatened to throw a brick at his brother, causing James to grab a brick in response. Michael threw his brick.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, Michael threw his brick.
Oh, yeah? Well, fuck you.
Causing a small cut to his brother's leg, James then countered and struck Michael in the right eye, which was soonly bloody and swollen, according to the Daytona Beach News. Both brothers
but then
were charged.
They didn't look alike anymore.
No, exactly. Both brothers were charged.
Hit him in the leg.
Exactly.
Like, is that, come on.
Let's see. What were they charged with? Aggravated battery.
Nice.
And taken to jail.
Aggravated brickery.
Yeah. James has been arrested twice since 2010, and Michael has been taken into custody 20 times. Michael's a bad boy.
Yeah, he's okay. He's the brick instigator, I'm thinking.
I think
it's really his fault.
His mother needs to
Don't add alcohol to the twins.
No. All right, that's going to wind up News of the Weird, so let's get back to some tunes. I haven't heard this band in a while. Let's play this. How about from Scorpion Child?
Oh, yeah.
This is King's Highway. News You Can't Use, Talking Real Metal, coming up on Rock and Metal Revival.
Hopefully Scorpion Child's going to have a new album out sometime soon.
Hey. Shut up or I'll throw this brick at you.
Fuck you, I got a brick too.
listening to Red and Jerry's Rock and Metal Revival. Keep it locked and keep it rocked.
We'll be right back. latest hard rock and metal news on Rock and Metal Revival.
All right, horns up, metalheads. Time to talk real metal. Grab the kids, bring them around the stereo speakers, and tell them to shut up and learn something.
Yeah, god right. Dang it.
Ex-Iron Maiden singer Paul Di'Anno says his children have pushed him to stay off drugs, and looks like it ain't working.
Yeah. No. Maybe they should push you to go get a fucking job and quit trying to be a singer anymore.
Go to the gym.
Yeah.
New Accept lineup performs in Greece. I hope they come to the States. I
wanted
see
to
them.
See you pronounce the name of that city Greece.
I didn't try. Slayer and Anthrax join forces for European tour. They're coming here with Megadeth.
Oh, yeah?
I think I'm going to go to that.
Who, Anthrax?
Slayer and Anthrax.
Slayer and Anthrax?
And Megadeth.
Here?
Together in Milwaukee.
No way. At the rave? Probably at the rave.
I don't know if it's at the rave or the Riverside.
Hopefully not the rave, man. I'd go to that.
Kiss frontman to develop global branding, licensing, and retail programs for Paul Stanley Royals and Rebels brand.
Woohoo! Can't wait. You're going to be decked out in that shit.
Yeah. You can tell he's been hanging around Gene Simmons too long.
Yeah.
Get this, Phil Lewis and Tracy Guns performed together.
Yeah, I know. That's kind of cool.
Very cool.
Yeah, that would be all right.
Oh, I can't wait to read this. Sebastian Bach, 18 in Life on Skid Row, memoir due out in January.
Wow, what a clever title.
I'll wait for the movie.
Yeah, I'll wait for the movie. Too.
Queensrÿche's Eddie Jackson being restricted to only performing certain songs was really difficult.
Yeah, but they really knew those songs very good.
Exactly. Sharon Osbourne, Lars Ulrich is a bit of a big mouth who needs a good slap sometimes, but we love him. We feel the same way about you, Sharon, but we don't love you.
Yeah, and you need more than a slap.
Punch,
You need to get a brick.
You need to be donkey punched.
Slap you with a brick.
Yeah, mushroom stamp.
Yeah.
All right, man dies after falling from catwalk during Chevelle concert.
Well,
he's probably trying to get out.
He was killing himself. Yeah. It was suicide. I don't blame him.
Linkin Park Volbeat performances at Rocklahoma canceled due to inclement weather. You know what that tells me?
That tells
that even
me
God
that
thinks they suck.
Yeah, that tells me that was a good day to go to the room. Yeah. That made this concert even better.
Ozzy Osbourne's wife manager Sharon to take leave from talk show because of exhaustion.
Because
she talks too much?
Maybe
she's such a bitch.
Yeah, just take some time out of being such a conniving, evil, wicked woman.
Yeah.
And maybe you won't be so fucking tired.
Judas Priest, Rob Halford on Defenders of the Faith. Fans love that record so much.
Yeah, it's not one of my top. Yeah. Wouldn't be in my top 10 of their albums.
I think it'd be in my top 10, but I don't think it'd be in my top 5.
Yeah.
Megadeth and Anthrax bassists are putting finishing touches on Altitudes and Attitude full-length album.
I know, Turbo Lover is your favorite. You just love the image of
you and Rob. There you go. Ex-Skid Row drummer Rob Elfusu, I tried to three times to get Rachel Boland and Sebastian Bach in a room to talk. I think they should just make an MMA match.
Yeah, let them fight it out.
If Sebastian wins, Rachel has to let him back in the band.
Yeah, quit sitting there taking shots at each other and... In the news and all that shit, and sit down and fucking talk.
Yeah, like men. Sebastian Bach, I haven't given Rachel Boland any reason to dislike me in 19 years. I can't believe that, but you said it.
You've given him plenty of reasons.
And Whitesnake's David Coverdale says his critics are wasting their hate.
Yeah, I don't like that new album, though.
I wasn't real thrilled with it.
No, he can't sing. He can't hit those notes anymore. Why try that?
I like the last one he did with Doug Aldridge.
Yeah, the Whitesnake one, where he's being himself now instead of trying to be himself back then, because he can't hit those notes, and the songs just sound dated. Sounded dated.
Yeah.
You know, except for the music, there was some good,
music's good. I mean, Red Beach and those guys kick ass.
So,
all right, well, that winds up talking real metal, news you can't use, and coming up a week from Friday, we're going to be heading in to see our friend Anthony Esposito.
Man, we got a long road trip, don't we?
Yeah, all the way, 6 miles?
Yeah.
Up to see a Red Dragon Cartel from their debut album, This Is Deceived.
Just have him come check out my fretless bass.
We'll just take it to him.
Yeah.
On Rockin' Metal Revival. We'll be right back.